our founder, chairman of the board, and CEO of Global Sanki, Alejandro Lopez Tello. How are you?
This is from lower my voice.
Omotenashi. Omotenashi is part of our philosophy. It's an ancient Japanese philosophy, and it's a secret to Japanese service model. They have been using it for many centuries, and that's why they are so successful in business. I didn't know about this until I met our partners, and they started explaining me how this works. And I was really impressed on all this methodology, all this way of serving from the heart. That is omotenashi. I will share a little bit more about this philosophy with you, but it's the heart of the Japanese quality as well. Why the service is so important in Japan? Well, besides having the most centenarians in the world, they also have the most centenarian companies in the world. The first company, named Kongo Gumi, is the oldest Japanese company. It started in 562, long time ago, and it already exists. Today, Japan has more than 20,000 companies that are more than 100 years old. Imagine 20,000 companies. So, what's the secret? What's the magic behind this? Well, the ability to change. The Japanese companies have been able to evolve, to change throughout time. And customers are always our roadmap. Customers are always changing. Customers are changing and evolving very, very fast, and now faster than ever, because of social media, because of the internet. So the evolution is going faster and faster and faster. We need to develop an ability to change as a company, as an organization, as leaders, as customers. You need to evolve. You need to change. That's the secret. As long as the customers change, Sanki will change. We will always be adjusting, operationally speaking, to their needs. That's the plan. That's the secret. That's why we're planning to have more a company that will be more than 100 years old. And the Japanese developed the love for the customers. And the way to show that love was through quality, the quality of their products and services. That's how they show the love and respect, which comes from the omotenashi philosophy. So that's what you experience when you go to Japan. Has someone here been in Japan? Not many? Okay, just a few of you. As soon as you get out of the plane, you really feel this respect. You really feel this love. It's impressive. It's so powerful. It's so strong. And I didn't know that since you are very young in Japan, you're trained in omotenashi, in kindergartens, in primary schools, elementary schools, etc. They are trained in omotenashi. So it's part of their culture now, And they do it naturally. It's not because they're going to get a tip. It's not because they're going to be paid. They just respect and love you. And it's very interesting. And we have adopted this philosophy in Sanki. Business-wise, what's the interesting thing? That if you change, you can have stability. You can have growth. The growth and stability come from the capacity and your ability to change throughout time. So, in Sanki, as you've seen, we just have 5 years. We're a five-year-old company. But with Belash, we have three versions. The version that we're today selling is the third version of the Orisol technology. The third one in 5 years. We're constantly evolving, constantly changing. Evolution, evolution, change, stability, growth. What does samotinashi mean? There's not an exact translation in Spanish or English to this word, but it's a combination of all this. Surface, omote, less, nashi, honesty, hospitality. All these words work together. To be honest, to be brutally honest, to be sincere. So at the end, business-wise again, the Japanese business people are always anticipating to the needs. It's not only satisfying the needs of our customers. It's anticipating to those needs. It's a completely different story. To anticipate the needs of our customers. To have an insightful understanding of those needs and desires. It's a thoughtful caring about each customer's well-being. And in this part of the world, we're not that used to it anymore. Sometimes when I go to a restaurant, I see the waiter, how they treat us. And it's anti-multinational. Anti-multinational. They're just waiting for the money. They're just waiting for the tip. But they are not respecting you. They're not loving you. They're not caring about you. We need to develop this culture. We need to show this philosophy again to the people. Because all human beings deserve respect, deserve love. So that's what we are promoting through Sanki, to treat individuals as true individuals. And everything started in the 16th century throughout this Sato tea ceremony. In the middle of the 16th century, Sen no Rikyu set the rules for this tea ceremony. And what he wanted is to show the Japanese spirit, the spirit of Japanese manner, throughout harmony, respect, purity, and tranquility. All those three, all these four words together. And they use this word in Japanese, ichigo, ichie. Ichigo, ichie, which means that you have a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to create a first good impression. You just have a once-life opportunity to create a first good impression. What a great philosophy. And that's why I tell you that as soon as you leave that airplane, you feel everywhere. I've been lost many times in the subway in Tokyo, which is sometimes difficult. If you're lost, you have a map. Imagine, they don't speak English, they don't speak Spanish, of course. They just speak Japanese. You have your map in English. They are not able to read your letters. And they end up helping you. I've been lost many times, and many, it's impressive. They see you lost, and people that you don't know immediately get in touch with you. And they tell you, of course, in Japanese, and they just move like this. You understand that they are asking, do you need my help? You said, yeah, I need to go over here, and you just point something in the map. And they tell you, okay, follow me, come with me. And it's impressive because you're not used to it. You want me to follow you? Why? And you start following them, and they put you in this exact spot that you need to be in order to get the train that you're waiting for. And I have so many examples of how they respect you and how they love you just for being a human being. In Japan, there are no tips. You cannot tip anyone. The taxi drivers don't accept any tip. I was impressed with that. Here, if you don't tip, the drivers get angry. There, they get angry if you try to tip them. The opposite. Completely the opposite. It's impressive. Ichigo. Ichie. So what happens at the end is the most aggressive way of doing business. is the most aggressive way of doing business. Because if you love them, you want to return, you want to be there, you want to share with them, you want to collaborate with them, you want to buy their products, you want to buy their services, you want to use their services. Because you feel very well with them. Very well. And at the end, you end up buying their products. Of course, their products have a lot of quality, security. That's the way to show their love and respect. So all these philosophies started some centuries ago. And I would like to share with you a video. It's a fast video, but I think that an image tells more than 1,000 words. So let's see this video of how, and try, after understanding some, this is just the basic of a multinational, but after understanding this basic information, try to see the video from this point of view. Research and development, clinical trials, Pasteur Institute, etc., etc. All this innovation that we have behind our products. But the second very important element is human. Human leadership. Human leadership. Codes of honor, omotenashi, that will support the permanent evolution of the organization. Because this is about people. This is about serving people. Truly serving, truly being honest, sincere. And that's what we need here. That's what our the society, not the network marketing industry, the society needs. We need to respect and love each other. We're still fighting, 2015, we're still fighting wars everywhere. Lots of problems. Why can't we love each other as human beings and respect us? And that is truly network marketing. So we have created this among the national project in 2015, and we are starting in the US just today to spread this word. It's your moment. It's the time for you to share it with everyone else. Can I count with you?
Yes.
You want to share it? You think this is a philosophy that suits you?
Yes.
That fits with you?
Yes.
Okay. Because that takes us to our vision in the coming 5 years, our Sanki vision 2020. Where we need to compare time versus timing. The majority of us, the average people, just have a sense of time, but not a sense of timing. It's completely different. The sense of time is limited. The sense of timing is unlimited. It's timeless. We are in a fast food society, a microwave society, where time is very important. We want the hamburger like this. We want our tea, our hot tea immediately, in 30 seconds. Well, in Sanki, we don't want that. We want you to understand that this is the perfect timing for you. We want to $200 million, $500 million, $1 million company in the future. But without people that don't want to destroy the company. We want people that really are connected with this philosophy in the long term. That's why we don't, as I said before, we don't want to be the fastest growing company in America. We don't want that. We just want to be connecting with the right people in the right timing. I can sell you the short time to buy you the long term. I can sell you the short term to buy you always the long term. We have a roadmap to build this 100-year company, year-old company. We have been working very hard. We have a lot of innovation. Today we just showed two of the coming innovations, the Agros technology, the Inner Seven technology, but we have many other, or just waiting there. But we need to make this market needs to grow. Because as I said, this is the market to connect, to collaborate with the whole of the, with the rest of the world. Because this is a multicultural country. You have everything here compared to other countries in the world. That's the power of the United States. That's the strength of the United States. All these multicultural people that live here. So many talents, so many options, so many opportunities. And that's why we decided to bet on this market. If we compare, and we show this graph between time and timing, we can see that if you see this as your life, you will have ups and downs, ups and downs, ups and downs. In this profession, you will also have ups and downs. You will have ups and downs, ups and downs. But many times when you're going down, at this moment, you decide to quit. You decide to go to something else and start all over again from here, or from here, or from here, 5, 10, 15, 20 years after. Not understanding that the timing is very important. If you connect with the timing, then you don't need to continue falling down. You don't need it. And that's why this is very important for us to create this community, to create this philosophy that will stick us together. That's why we have created this Sanki community. Thinking, who has a son or a daughter here? The majority. Do you have someone? You have children? What happens with them? Sometimes they go up, they go down, but you help them, the family helps them to continue growing, to continue evolving in their timing. As a business, as a Sanki community, we have created all this movement, all this community to stick us together, to make us stronger. And these are the five elements that we are promoting through Sanki. This goes beyond a network marketing company. We have these five elements, of course, health and science. We have been talking about health and science all day long. But there are other five elements. For example, evolution and humanity. That's why we have this multinational concept and philosophy for the whole company. You don't receive education for humanity, for leadership in your school. You don't receive that. So that's why we're implementing this leadership and, of course, humanity trainings throughout all this Sanki community, throughout all these Sanki trainings. Education and culture. I will show you an example of how we're trying to educate the people in a very simple but powerful way. I will just show you in a few minutes what we're doing, for example. Innovation and creativity. We are creators of our own innovation. We don't need to buy it. We create it. We own it. And that's very powerful. That's very valuable. That's why we have evolution. That's why we have value innovation. Nutrition and agriculture. We're also developing technologies that will help the agriculture to grow faster without pesticides. For example, imagine nanotechnology used in the crops, in the harvest of all types of seeds, all types of plants, all types of fruits. We already started that in Japan, bringing a new type of rice. In Japan, of course, the rice consumption is very high, and we now have a nanobiotechnological rice that has many active ingredients, that has more nutrient power than the normal rice. So that's the type of things that we're creating. And that's the Sanki community. So that's what network marketing is about, to create a strong community. When you go down, we are here to support you. We are here to help you evolve, continue changing, continue growing. Because we don't want you to have 5 more years, 10 more years, and start all over again. We want to create a safe place, a safe community for you. That's what is behind the Sanki philosophy, the Sanki mission, the Sanki vision. And you can be part of this. You can be part and create this together with us. We need to build a huge American Sanki community. An example of what we're doing. Of course, we are together the most obese countries in the world, US and Mexico. More than 30% of the population is obese. Just a few countries are in red. Here we are. What's happening? Well, of course, we're eating a lot of carbohydrates, lots of sugars. And to change that habit is very difficult because we love sweets, we love desserts. Why? Because desserts makes us happy. Desserts make us feel different. We love the flavor. We love the taste. That's why we end up having a dessert in a good meal. But why do we love desserts? Because we really enjoy it. We really love it. So how can we change this? How can we change those habits? Well, we created this project called Delicious and Healthy. So we connected, we collaborated, because this is about collaboration throughout the world, with, for example, this chef, Keiko Nagai. She's one of the top chefs in the world for desserts. She worked with a 3 Michelin star chef in France called, what's his name? There's a restaurant. It's not Alain Ducasse, it's sorry, I don't remember. He has a restaurant in Las Vegas, actually, in the Mandarin Oriental. Maybe you know the name. But she worked with him for many years in France. She became the dessert chef for this super chef, super famous chef. He has restaurants all around the world. So we connected with Keiko, and we asked her, please create some healthy desserts that taste delicious. That's the issue, because when we have access to a healthy dessert, we don't like the flavor, we don't like the taste. So with Mizuho and Naso, they created delicious and healthy desserts at the same time. So we launched this, we started connecting with media, and we connected with this concept of the Ondo. Today, we're launching this concept. Ondo means temperature in Japanese. So this could be seen as a normal thermal, but it isn't, because it's a device that could help you, a technological device that could help you have a healthier soup, healthier fruits that you can carry on with you throughout the day. And you can be even cooking raw meats, raw foods, raw vegetables while you're working, because this cylinder keeps the temperature for many hours. So you can put boiled water in here, very hot water, put some raw vegetables, and go to work, go to the Sanki. And at the lunchtime, you will have a very nicely cooked soup with vegetables, instead of having a fast food, a burger in McDonald's or wherever, or a Starbucks sandwich. And you can start having a healthier habit, a healthier lifestyle. That is Ondo, connected with the Delgea project. So it's a nice piece. It's of course stainless steel, easy to wash, etc. But the important thing is that you can use it, of course, to have your belash, super cold belash. It will be kept cold all day long, even though it's super hot outside. It will still be cold, or it will still be hot. If you put a hot kernel tea, you can keep it hot, or a coffee, or whatever, hot during the whole day. You like the idea? You like this device? It's called Ondo, and today we have it. The price, if you want to buy it, is $14.95. But if you buy today 2 belash plus 2 kernel, you will get it for free. Okay? So, and inside you will have the price. Inside, if you buy this promotion, you will get a surprise of some sachets in here. So ask for the surprise, because you will have that surprise outside. Okay? So at the end, we have this vision, the 2015-2020 vision, that will end up in the Olympic Games. It's destiny, I don't know. But in 2020, Tokyo, Japan, will have the Olympic Games. Who would like to be there? Yeah. Who would like to be there at the Olympics? With us, with Sanki, with Tokyo, with Japanese, with French, with Americans, with... I don't know how many people will have there. But we have 5 years to make it happen. 2020, Olympic Games, Tokyo. What's our motto? To be higher, our Olympic Sanki motto. To go higher, to move faster, and to share the love and respect that we have for human beings. Omotenashi philosophy. Good afternoon, see you in a couple of minutes.
great morning, do you not agree?
Yes.
Absolutely. Okay, two things. Number one, I'm gonna ask for a favor. We have to be back and start